Now, Dr. Ostfeld, you have written and talked openly about a molecule known as TMAO, which is a sneaky molecule which is found in particular types of food. So can you explain to us what is TMAO, where is TMAO found, and why should people with diabetes in particular care about it?
Absolutely. And if it's okay, I'd like to take a step back and then jump forward into it. There is so much evidence, particularly in regard to heart disease and also with diabetes, that supports the overwhelming benefit of a plant-based diet. The reason, one of the reasons I talk about trimethylamine oxide is because it's a very important mechanistic conversation as to why eating more of a plant-based diet will be helpful. That is one of many, many, many mechanisms that support the benefits of a plant-based diet and add additional credibility to the millions of patients who have been studied in very large observational or epidemiologic type studies that support the beneficial aspects of a plant-based diet. And these mechanistic things like trimethylamine oxide also support the benefits seen in randomized controlled trials in patients, you know, by Dr. Ornish and Dr. Barnard, for patients with heart disease or with diabetes. So it's extremely useful, I think, that to have a broad evidence base that supports the benefit of a plant-based diet. And we have large epidemiologic studies, mechanistic studies, randomized controlled trials, observational studies. So it all adds up to paint the same kind of picture. Trimethylamine oxide is one of the mechanisms that supports the benefit of a plant-based diet. So what am I talking about? Well, TMAO is an organic compound that basically you don't want. Why is that? The reason you don't want it is because it may raise your cholesterol levels. It can be damaging to blood vessels. And in a way that lets cholesterol deposit in the walls of the blood vessel, promoting heart disease and potentially leading to a heart attack. You don't want it because we know, and also it can be very pro-inflammatory, which is not a helpful health thing. And we know that higher levels of trimethylamine oxide in your body is associated with dying earlier. It's associated with more heart disease. It's associated with more diabetes. Higher levels are associated with more diabetes. So who cares? Like, what can you do about it? Well, it turns out, it seems like there's a good bit you can do about it. There was a very interesting study that was done, and they took people who are omnivores, meaning eat all kinds of foods, versus vegans. And then they fed them a steak. They had the omnivores eat a steak and the vegans eat a steak. And the omnivores, when they did that, their body made a whole bunch of TMAO or trimethylamine oxide. But when the vegans ate that steak, they made virtually none, virtually none. So what's going on? Well, it turns out it's our gut bacteria that's going on, because it's subtle differences in the gut bacteria between omnivores and vegans that accounts for the difference in trimethylamine oxide formation. When you eat animal products, you select for different gut bacteria that can lead to TMAO formation. When you eat a plant-based diet, you virtually select for none of them. And that shift between kind of better gut bacteria, better microbiome, to worse can happen very quickly, even in the course of a couple of days. The shifts can be very quick. And so the reason that they fed the people the steak is that a substance called L-carnitine is in the steak, which is felt to be the substrate that the gut bacteria work on that ultimately leads to trimethylamine oxide formation. Now, interestingly, L-carnitine is structurally similar to choline. Who cares? Well, choline is in chicken. Choline is in fish. Choline is in dairy. So when you, it's in egg whites. So when you eat those things, you lead your body to the formation of trimethylamine oxide. But wait a second, you know, choline is a required nutrient. But the good news is you can get it from plants. You know, but Dr. Osfeld, you just said if you eat choline, you can make trimethylamine oxide. But when you get your choline from plants, which you very easily can, you do not select for the gut bacteria that leads to the formation of trimethylamine oxide. So you get the choline and dozens of other amazing anti-inflammatory, antioxidant nutrients, phytonutrients in plants, protecting yourself from the formation of trimethylamine oxide. You don't want it. It leads to higher cholesterol levels, worse blood vessel function, more cholesterol in the walls of blood vessels, is associated with more diabetes. And by eating a plant-based diet, selecting for the appropriate gut bacteria, you can lead to yourself having much lower levels of TMAO in your body. Now, interestingly, it's wonderful that that was identified and we can describe that, because it's beautiful to have a mechanistic reason to support the randomized trials and the observational studies. And there are multiple other mechanisms as well. For example, there's a compound called Nu5GC. Now, I haven't talked about this in a little while, so I may trip over myself, but it called Nu5GC. That is actually naturally in the cells of carnivores, true carnivores. It's not in our cells because we are not true carnivores for many reasons that we could dive into if you like. So what? Well, these researchers in San Diego noticed that true carnivores were getting much less cancer, the animals, than those who eat animals who are not true carnivores. So they said, well, gosh, you know, maybe the people who are not true carnivores don't have Nu5GC naturally in their body like we do not. Maybe when we eat Nu5GC, this compound, we see it as foreign and create an immune reaction. Our body attacks it and creates all kinds of inflammation. So they did this test in I forget if it was mice or rats, but they did a test in them, and they created a model of rats or mice that did not have Nu5GC. So they're kind of like us. And then they had the normal rats or mice that have Nu5GC, and they fed them meat that has Nu5GC, kind of like the meat that we would eat on any given day. So what happened? Well, it turns out the mice that did not have Nu5GC in their body reacted to the Nu5GC they were eating, had tons of inflammation, much more cancer. That's what they found from the study. But interestingly, these investigators said, you know, okay, there was more cancer in the mice that we modified to seem more like humans, but there was also a ton of inflammation. And inflammation promotes heart disease and it promotes diabetes. So maybe, they said, one of the reasons that people eating meat may have more heart disease and more diabetes is because of the inflammation created by eating Nu5GC. So it's another pillar of mechanistic evidence. And the list goes on and on. The heme iron, the form of iron that we get when we eat animal products is different than the kind of iron we get from when we eat plant products. And our body's reaction to it is much different. The iron in animal products is pro-inflammatory, pro-oxidant, and can promote diabetes and heart disease, whereas the iron in plant products virtually does not. So yet another pillar. So it's really terrific, and the list goes on and on. And it just helps us feel that much more comfortable and inspired to recommend eating this way to our patients.